Hi everyone, today I'm going to show you one of the latest features for cross-platform C++ development in Visual Studio. My name is Tina McKinjit and I am a product manager on the Microsoft Visual C++ team. Now, Visual Studio provides the capability for users to develop from the comfort of a Windows instance of Visual Studio even when they want to target a Mac with their application. This is great and allows for users who love or want to try Visual Studio to use this powerful IDE when previously they weren't able to since they wanted to target a Mac. This is available in 17.3 Preview 2 or later version of Visual Studio, so feel free to download the latest version and give it a try. Now, I will show you how to target a Mac application from your Windows machine through Visual Studio. For the sake of the demo, I already have Xcode in the appropriate version of CMake, NinjaBuild, and LLDB and MyDebugger already installed on my target Mac. These can be downloaded from GitHub or a package manager. Please note, the CMake needs to be installed under your applications and be at least version 3.8. If you want to learn more about the commands needed to install these applications, you can take a look at our blog post on aka.ms/cppblog. These need to be installed for the remote debugging to work properly, but you may already have most of these already installed if you have used your Mac for C++ development before. First, we have to make sure our Mac is enabled for remote connections. To do that, we will go to System Preferences, and then select Sharing, and check here if Remote Login is selected and my user has access. If the application has a GUI, Remote Management needs to be enabled as well. I will note the global hostname of this machine as I will need to plug it into my Connection Manager on Visual Studio to establish a remote connection. Now that my Mac is set up for C++ development and able to be remoted into, I can now use Visual Studio on Windows to target this Mac. Moving over to my Windows computer that I will be developing on, I can open Visual Studio with the CMake repository I want to build on my Mac. Then I'll open the Connection Manager. As you can see, I already have a connection made to my target Mac's hostname, username, and password. If I want to add another connection, I can simply add a new connection using this button and add a new hostname, username, and password. Now, it can be used as a CMake target in either a CMake settings or CMake presets.json configuration. I will go to Tools, Options, and CMake to ensure that it always uses CMake presets.json for configuration. I'm using an open source project that builds with CMake for this demo, but any CMake project will work as long as it can compile on a Mac. From the first dropdown, which is a target machine dropdown, you can then select your target Mac machine, which is this option. This will start the CMake generation for this machine. This will take quite some time, so I will skip forward to when this is complete. Now that the CMake generation is complete, you can see that Visual Studio automatically detects this as a macOS debug system from the second dropdown. Next, we can go to this first play button and select from the dropdown whichever target application we want to run. For this example, I'll just choose a basic example with a GUI. After I press play, this will build on my Mac machine and you'll be able to see the GUI after some time. I will cut forward to when this is complete. Now you can see that the GUI is running on my Mac machine while the application is running on my Windows machine. Additionally, there is remote debugging support available, so I am able to set a breakpoint using the left panel at anywhere in the code, and the application will run and stop at this breakpoint and show the status of various debugging variables within the Mac machine. Additionally, there is IntelliSense functionality. I can type up some code and you can see that Visual Studio can detect what I am trying to type using IntelliSense despite targeting a Mac. So that's everything you need to get started with targeting a Mac machine from your Windows Visual Studio instance. Currently, this only supports Macs with Intel x64 chips on an OS version of at least 10.15 due to dependencies, but we are working to provide full M1 support soon. For now, M1 users can use Rosetta to work around this. Please let us know your thoughts on the process and be sure to check out the Pure Virtual C++ conference on April 26th for more C++ content.